In this video, we're going to be discussing how you can find a work from home job for developers in 2021. Since the COVID has hit in 2020, things have been very different in the job market. Nowadays, there are a lot more companies that are willing to accept remote workers. And this is fantastic if you really want to work from home and previously you couldn't do that. So in the past, many companies required you to be in their office in order to do the work, which for the type of job that we have for web developers and software developers, is really not essential that you're in the office at all. But from the perspective of the employer, it does make sense to have staff in the office as it is easier to control what work is being done. And having staff in the office makes it easier to see what problems are being encountered. So since the pandemic has happened, there are a lot more employers that are looking to hire remote developers. It just makes it easier now to do things remotely because of the complications of COVID-19. So let's look at some of the websites that you can use in 2021 to find a job as a remote developer. So the first website I'm going to look at is Remotive, and I've actually only just discovered this website recently, but it does look quite promising in terms of the jobs that are offered there. And you also have the ability to toggle US only jobs, so you can turn that off if you're outside of the US. So that will make it easier to find jobs that are relevant to you. And I really like the messaging that they have on the top of the website. So it really sells the point of working from home, the benefits from working from home. And another useful feature on this website is that it allows you to browse remote companies. So you can pick the company that you're looking for and see what job opportunities that they have open right at this moment. So if you click on a company name, then you can see the different categories. Now in this particular case, they don't have any jobs, but there are many other companies that do have jobs available. And the second website we will be looking at is AngelList. And this is a website I have been using for quite some time. And it has some really nice features that make it easy to find the job that you're looking for. One of the things I really like about this website is how they have these tags on each job. So you can see that in this case, it is highly rated, it is COVID friendly, so they're hiring even though COVID is happening, and there's a good work-life balance, and it is recently funded. So some of these things will help you to decide if this company is a good fit for you as a developer. And another feature I really like on this website that most of the sites don't have is the ability to see what the pay will be like for that job. So what is the pay range for that job based on your experience? So here we can see that this job is from $105,000 up until $145,000. So depending on how much experience you have, where you will sit within that threshold, but it gives you a really good idea about what kind of company you're working for and what is the possibilities in terms of compensation. And the third website we will be looking at is Remote OK. And this is a website that was built by Peter Levels. And he is very active in creating products around digital nomads. And while it does have limited jobs in the search terms I was looking for, there are still quite a few good jobs that allow you to work remotely and from any location that you want. The fourth website that we will look at is We Work Remotely, and this is a very popular website for finding remote jobs. So we can search at the top of the website. So we'll search here for Node.js as an example. And you can see that there are a number of jobs that have been returned. So on the listing page, we don't see a whole lot of information, but once we click inside here, we can see that it is a full-time role as a full-stack developer. And in this case, it's for Europeans only. And quite often the reason for this is due to the time zone, but I guess in some ways, if they're paying in the same currency, it just makes things easier for them in terms of reporting. But this website gives you quite a bit of information about each of these jobs. So there's a good amount of information there, and there is quite a lot of new jobs added to this website. So I'd recommend checking out this website if you're looking for a remote job as a developer. And the final website we will look at is Stack Overflow Jobs. So Stack Overflow Jobs is quite a common place to find work as a remote developer. There are so many developers on this website every day that it makes sense for a remote job to be advertised here. Now again, there are only a limited number of jobs here, but if you search around the keywords, you may find something that is a very good opportunity here. So we can see that they do have a lot of options on this website. So we can filter by the salary, by the location, by the job perks. But in the case of searching for a job as a developer, it really depends on what type of developer you are and how many jobs are available, whether you will actually want to use these filters or not. So generally, I will just do the search term without the filters, but you can experiment with this and see what gives you the best results. Let me know in the comments if you've used any of these websites to find a remote job as a developer. And other than that, I just want to thank you for watching this video. Make sure to hit the like button and subscribe if you have not already subscribed to the channel. And I will see you all in the next one.